Praise the Lord.
To God be the glory. To our Lord Jesus Christ be the glory and honor and praise. Lagi nating dakilahin ang Diyos, ang ating Panginoong Hesukristo. Siya yung ating kapangyarihan, siya yung ating kalakasan, siya yung ating katagumpayan to conquer the entire world. Dahil sa kanya galing ang salita na ito, that before the end of this world, His gospel must be proclaimed. The gospel of the kingdom of God must be proclaimed. At ang tanong, how the people will listen unto it? Paano ang mga tao makikinig nito? Kung paano niya nagather yung mga tao noon by the thousands because of His power and because of His miracles, ganun din, He will shake again the nations, He will shake again all level of people of this world. Siya ang gagawa nito. Tayo ay gagamitin ng Diyos to proclaim the salvation of God. Ang kaligtasan ng Diyos ang siyang ating ipoproclaim sa lahat ng mga tao kung saan man tayo ipadala ng ating Panginoong Diyos. It must be God will send us. Kaya nga sinabi dyan, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved, but how can they call in Him in whom they have not believed? And how can they believe in Him they have not heard? And how can they hear except there is a preacher? And how can a preacher preach except he is sent by God? Kaya pupunta tayo, not sent by us, not sent by man, but pupunta tayo, we will go being sent by the living God. Praise the Lord! Para i-proclaim natin ang gospel of the kingdom of God. Anong ibig sabihin, proclaiming the gospel of the kingdom of God? Let us have crusade. What is crusade? That is something by girls. Campaign. Yung bang masigasig na kumpanya. Matapang na kumpanya. Powerful na kumpanya sa harapan ng madla, sa harapan ng mga tao, para sila iligtas sa kapangyarihan ng Diablo. And this is not a joke. This must be done only by God alone. Kasi siya lang yung may kapangyarihan na makatalo kay Satanas sa sanglibutang ito. So, kailangan ipaintindi natin sa mga tao what is the way of salvation. Of course, Jesus is the way. Kailangan ipaalam natin how can the people can be set free from the bondage of all sins, of all vices, of all worldly, earthly pleasures, of all lust of the flesh, lust of the eyes, and pride of life. Maraming mga tao that they are in the bondage of all this kind of iniquities. If not, kung di sila mapalaya, they are bound to hell because the wages of sin is death. Malaki man o maliit, lahat ng mga tao kinakailangan ng Savior. Praise the Lord! At yan na ngayon. Ang nasa paligid natin, napakarami. So, let us pray to God to equip us with all His wisdom, with all His knowledge, how to preach His gospel, the power of salvation. How can the people repent? Paano ang tao magsisisi? How can the people will be enlightened? Paano sila maliliwanagan? How can they be convicted with a strong conviction that even Satan cannot hold them? Praise the Lord! We should ask God His power and His strength. Of course, niligtas tayo ng ating Panginoong Diyos para tayo gamitin sa pagligtas that is already given. Meron ditong kasaysayan sa Biblia, isang napakasamang babae, but how God saved her? Paano siya niligtas ng Diyos sa kanyang karumihan, sa kanyang kasalanan? Basahin natin ang kanyang kwento. John 8:1-11.
Praise the Lord. Jesus went unto the Mount of Olives, and early in the morning he came again into the temple, and all the people came unto him, and he sat down and taught them. And the scribes and the Pharisees brought unto him a woman taken in adultery. And when they had set her in the midst, they say unto him, Master, this woman was taken in adultery in the very act. Now Moses in the law commanded us that such should be stoned. But what sayest thou? This they said, tempting him, that they might have to accuse him. But Jesus stooped down, and with his finger wrote on the ground, as though he heard them not. So when they continued asking him, he lifted up himself and said unto them, He that is without sin among you, let him first cast a stone at her. And again he stooped down and wrote on the ground. And they which heard it, being convicted by their own conscience, went out one by one, beginning at the eldest, even unto the last. And Jesus was left alone, and the woman standing in the midst. When Jesus had lifted up himself and saw none but the woman, he said unto her, Woman, where are those thine accusers? Has no man condemned thee? She said, No man, Lord. And Jesus said unto her, Neither do I condemn thee. Go and sin no more.
Ayan. Praise the Lord. Basahin ko muna itong verse 6. Bakit nangyari ito sa babaeng ito? Meron kasi silang tinatawag na plano. This has been well planned and well done by the so-called Pharisees and scribes. Matagal na nilang hinahanapan si Jesus Christ ng butas. Matagal na nilang hinahanapan si Lord Jesus Christ ng paraan. Paano siya matrap? Paano siya makornered? Paano siya mahatulan sa kanyang kapahamakan na mawala na siya sa kanilang presensya? You know why? Basahin ko muna yung verse 6. This they said, tempting him. What do you mean, tempting him? Testing him that they might have to accuse him. Para meron lang talaga silang makita na butas na pwede nilang i-accuse sa kanya that will lead him to be killed. Either by crucifixion, either by stoning, basta mamatay siya. Their plan is to kill him. Their plan is to remove him out of their sight. You know why? Bakit ginagawa nila ito? Because Jesus is more popular than them. They cannot beat Jesus. They cannot hold people thronging him. Di nila kayang pigilan ang mga tao lalapit sa kanya. Hindi nila mapigilan ang mga tao na mga pinagaling ng ating Panginoong Hesus Kristo to speak what they have received from Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord! The longer Jesus Christ exists in their presence, the more they are being pinned down. Kaya galit na galit sila kay Lord Jesus Christ because Jesus is more popular than them. At gusto nilang hilain si Jesus Christ, ibagsak! Yun ang kanilang objective. Tapos gusto nilang ipaintindi sa mga tao He is not the Messiah which Israel are waiting. He should not. Yun lagi nila, hindi sila naniwala kay Jesus that He is the Messiah. Tapos magbigay kagad sila ng mga accusation. If He is the Messiah, we saw Him when He walked to Bethesda. You know Bethesda. He asked someone there. Hindi nila sinabi, pinagaling. Naalala niyo yung 38? Crippled man waiting for the angel in that pool of Bethesda. But maraming mauna sa kanya. And he waited until 38 years and nobody can bring him to that pool until Jesus Christ came in his life. And Jesus said, "Man, has anybody to carry you to that pool?" Then Jesus said, "Stand up and walk and take up your bed." Yun ang accusation nila kay Jesus. We saw Jesus when He walked to Bethesda. He asked someone to take His bed in the Sabbath day. He never observed the law of God. Kasi ito kasi yung mga Pharisees na ito. They are showing themselves that they are obedient to the law of Moses. That's why there were passages here in the Bible. No, we are the followers of Moses. We are not followers of Jesus. Yun ang sinasabi nila. We are of Moses. Yun ang inaccuse nila. Ano pa ang accusation nila sa ating Panginoong Hesukristo? Lagi nilang hinahanapan ang ating Panginoong Hesukristo. Isa pa, pinulaan nila si Jesus Christ. Bakit daw tinanggap niya yung hospitality ng isang taong napakabaho, napakarumi? The sinner, the most sinner in that place, Zacchaeus. If he would be a prophet of God, if he would be the Messiah, he ought to know what filthy is that man. And yet, pumasok siya sa bahay ng tao na iyan. Yun ang mga accusations nila sa ating Panginoong Hesukristo. They never knew that Jesus was the friend of sinners. Di nila alam, Jesus seeking the sinners. Di nila alam, that is His main purpose. That's why Jesus said, "I came not for the righteous, but for the sinners to repentance." Praise the Lord! Kaya until that moment, they are trying to find trap, snare to Jesus, how they accuse Him and put Him to death. Isip nila, "Let us bring an adulterous woman. Then let us hear what he will say. And we will catch his words from his mouth." So either lang sa dalawa. Kung hindi mag-agree si Jesus, pag hindi magsabi si Jesus Christ after they ask Him the opinion na we caught this woman in the act of adultery and according to the law of Moses, he must be put to death by stoning. At yung mga tao na yun nagdala na ng mga bato. Nandiyan na sa bulsa nila. Prepared. Well plan eh. Plano na eh. Plano na. Yun ang kanilang plano. Pag hindi ito mag-agree sa atin to fulfill the law of Moses, then we have something to accuse him that he is not obedient to the law of God. And beside that, if he agree with us, he will be also trapped. If he condemn this woman to death, he must be arrested. He must be arrested because only during that occupation of the Roman forces, during the occupation of the Roman forces, you cannot do death sentence. It must be by the Roman occupation forces. Kaya tinan mo si Jesus was sentenced in the front of the governor, Roman governor. You cannot do any death sentences by yourself. It must be out of the Roman occupation forces. So, marami silang tinitingnan na anggel ba? Paano nila matrap ang ating Panginoong Hesus Kristo? At kung sabi man niya na hindi hatulan ang babae, doon naman siya mahuhulog, disobedient naman siya sa law of Moses. Yun ang mga angels na kanilang hinihintay. And how could we imagine they catch woman in the act of adultery? As what they said, we caught this in the act of adultery. Do you think that woman didn't resist the arrest? Especially, they don't have the so-called warrant of arrest. Basta pinick up lang nila yung babae, siguro pinick up nila yung sa mga motels. Nag-scream talaga yung babae, I believe. She screamed. She screamed, she screamed, she screamed. But she was overcome by this authorarian. Yung bang nag-ano ng authority ba? Kasi ano ito eh? Parisis ito eh. They are powerful during that time. They are the people who are, we may call them authoritative sila ba? May kapangyarihan sila. Wala, hindi niya na-resist. Until that woman, out of her scream, out of her resistance, she was overcame by them. Hanggang palapit ng palapit na. And this early in the morning happened. Early in the morning, when Jesus Christ went to that temple, having all the people coming in to listen his sermons. Early in the morning, there was suddenly woman was being kicked before him. Parang sinipa na yung babae ba? Pagsipa sa kanya, then she dropped at the feet of Jesus. Then, bago niya narinig ang lahat. Bago niya narinig ang mga sigaw ng mga tao, she looked at the eyes of Jesus. And it so happened, Jesus looked down to her. Then she saw the eyes of Jesus, the eyes of a sinless man. It is first time for her to see an eyes of a sinless person. Alam mo si Jesus, pag tumingin niyan sa kanino, you can feel something. Tingnan mo yung nag-preach ako doon sa Chinese. Yung atheist. Why he was convicted? Why he was touched? Why he agree? Why? With the preaching of the Word of God. Anong sinabi niya sa akin? I saw with your eyes the truth. Who is the truth? Jesus, praise the Lord! Na nag-set free sa kanya from his unbelief. How much more if personally Jesus Christ will look at someone? Sa isip ng babae. Tapos nung narinig na niya yung accusation, Jesus! this woman we caught in the act of adultery. Moses said, according to the law of Moses, he should be put to death by stoning. What do you say? What thou sayest? What is your opinion? Then Jesus stooped down, as if he hears nothing. Parang wala lang siyang narinig. Writing on the ground. Then yung babae, sa isip niya, convicted ang babae, guilty ang babae. Wala na siyang mapuntahan eh. She is just waiting. What will be the verdict of Jesus? Because she saw Jesus is a sinless man. Then, in her mind, whatever the verdict, whatever the judgment of this man, where they brought me, I will accept it. Because he is a righteous man. Then, sabi ng mga tao, what do you say, Jesus? Then Jesus stood before them. And he said, who among you who has no sin will be the first one to cast a stone against her? Din yung babae, sa nervyos niya, sa takot niya, she's expecting stone to be thrown because yun yung verdict ni Jesus. Sino sa inyo dyan? Ang walang kasalanan, siyang babato sa babaeng ito. Then yung mga Pharisees, alam yung mga Pharisees, karamihan dyan, mga senior ba? Mga senior na. Yung pinakamatanda doon, kasi nakalagay sa Bible, from oldest to the youngest. The Spirit of God did convict them. Kinonvict sila ng Espiritu ng Diyos. Eh, alam mo naman yung Pharisees, he knows the law of Moses. Then God reminded him the law of Moses. Law number one. Then he felt the conviction that he is guilty. Law number two, guilty siya. Number three, guilty siya. Hanggang 10, guilty siya. Alam mo yung mga Pharisees na yan. Sabi nga ni Jesus, they are sitting in the seat of Moses, but they themselves are found disobedient. God did convict them that they are guilty of the law of Moses. Yun ang pinakamatandang inunas ng Diyos to convict that he is guilty. Sumunod, yung ikalawang senior, sino pa yung mga Pharisees na yan? Then count to all people who are there. Anong nangyari? Kung sasakyan pa yan, this ship, the gear into reverse. They back off. The Bible said, from the eldest, from the oldest person to the youngest, went away. Tumalikod silang lahat. Tumalikod silang lahat. Lahat convicted that they are guilty also. And none of them na nagkuha ng bato dahil hindi siya guilty na bumato sa babae, all of them were guilty. Tanungin ko kayo, in that John chapter 8 na binasa kanina, is there any have no sin? Meron ba doon na walang kasalanan? Sagutin niyo ako. Meron ba doon na walang kasalanan? Is there anyone who have no sin? Yes or no? Yes or no? Para may narinig akong yes. May narinig akong yes. There is one! And that is Jesus Christ! Praise the Lord! He is the only one who has the right to stone to that woman to her death. And He has the only right to stone to you, to me, that we shall die because we are all guilty of sin. No one is righteous, no, not one. All have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Then, Jesus said, "Woman, is there anyone condemned you? After everybody left and Jesus alone left, si Lord Jesus Christ na lang ang naiwan. Lahat tumalikod. With, of course, the woman who never back off or hindi siya tumalikod. Then, sabi ng babae, tumingin ng babae, wala na lahat eh. Umuwi na lahat. Kasi isip ng mga parisi, I felt the guilt that I am a sinner. If I'm going to throw this stone which I have prepared for her, it will kill her. But it will bounce to me and it will also kill me too. Why should I cast this stone to kill her and will kill also myself?" Kaya walang bumatong. And this is how the Spirit of God convict everyone. And they went away. Go home! And after that, Jesus said, "Woman, is there any man or anyone that condemn you?" Yun na nga, nung tumingin na si babae, she said, "No one, Lord." Sabi ni Jesus, "Woman, neither I will not condemn thee. Neither I will not condemn thee. Go and sin no more." That is how salvation is being done with that woman, with Jesus alone. Because Jesus alone can save anyone of this world. Praise the Lord! The question is, if were you among the people, kung ikaw nandoon, what suppose you should do? Gagawin mo ba ang ginawa ng babae? What can we interpret the act of that woman? He never left. He never left. She felt that she is a sinner. She was convicted that she is guilty also. He is the number one guilty at that time. Pero yung mga tao, nandiyan na yung Savior nila. Nandiyan na the only Savior of the world. Hindi pa sila lumapit. next to that woman. But rather they choose the pride of life, and that is the reason why they will never humble. That is the reason why they never drove near to Jesus. Umatras sila. They choose. They stand. Their hypocrisy. They are so hypocrites. Alam mo, kung tutuusin, kung i-analyze mo yung itong chapter na binasa kanina, Jesus left alone. Where are the congregation which went together with him in the temple? They also leave. Malis din sila. Only Jesus left with the woman. And the salvation was given to that woman. Forgiveness of all your sins, it will never cause you to be in hell, but it will cause you to enter the kingdom of heaven, because the forgiveness of God is totally, absolutely pure and white. Jesus said, or God said, come, let us reason together. Though your sins be as scarlet, though they shall be white, or they shall be clean as snow. Salvation came upon the life of the accused person because she humbled herself. God resisted the proud, but he gave grace to the humble. Nag-humble. Alam mo anong importante ngayon sa atin? Let us be pure. We cannot do the work of God with even a single filthiness, even small or great. Sometimes people do say in their mind, oh, pastor, that message is not for me. I never committed adultery, neither fornication. I didn't kill. How about your small sins? Hindi ba kailangan niya ng forgiveness? How about yung tatlong kasalanan? Pag hindi yan napatawad, do you think you go to heaven? No! It can bring you to hell. Small or great sinner need Jesus Christ, need the salvation of God. Praise the Lord! But who will prevent you to come to him, to acknowledge and humble and be forgiven? It is the pride of life. It is the hypocrisy. That's why the Spirit of God cannot dwell in, and you don't have any thing that must be given to you. Such faith, such boldness, such love, such yung bang pag-volunteer mo to love God, to serve God, to be faithful unto God. Because there is something that hinders from the Spirit of God. May nag-aadlang. God hates Christians who are not growing. That's why the Bible says, if you do not bear fruit, I will cut you. Kaya ganun. Ngayon, ang tanong. Maraming magagawa ang babae sa mundong ito. But he cannot do adultery without the man. Where is the man? Because they say, this man we caught in the act of adultery. If it her sin that is being committed is adultery, she cannot commit that without a man. Where is the man? Saan ang lalaki? Bakit babae lang ang kanilang dinala? Then you can see something missing. Something missing. How do you think what Jesus Christ did wrote on the ground? Ano kaya ang sinulat ni Lord Jesus sa ground? And after he wrote, di ba, pag sigaw nila, umupo uli si Jesus, nagsulat na naman. You know, sa analysis ko lang, anong sinulat ni Jesus sa ground? The ground represents man. We came from the ground. Anong sinulat ni Jesus sa ground? It reflects, nag-reflect sa heart, sa mind ng mga nag-accuse sa kanya. Guilty. Guilty. Guilty! That's why no one cast a stone because all of them are guilty. Ganun. But not meaning to say, if you remain in His presence, humbling yourself, hindi ka papatawarin ng Diyos. May mga scholars ngayon na mga marunong ba? Scholar ko no sa Bible. You know, if you preach the truth, you don't need to be a scholar. You don't need to finish theology. One thing we need, and that one thing that can bring us to victory, even the world, we can overcome them. Saving and saving and saving multitude of souls. Alam mo mga sinasabi ng mga scholars, Jesus was wrong in His verdict, in His judgment, when He was asked by the accusers, what thou sayest? What do you say about this? He ought to fulfill the law of Moses. Yun ang kanilang, yun ang kanilang accusation . The question is, why Jesus didn't? Because He is the only person who has the right to cast a stone against her. Why she didn't? Bakit hindi niya ito ginawa? Because He is the only person who has the right. Kasi ang sabi ni Jesus, sino walang kasalanan sa inyo, siyang babato. Walang taong walang kasalanan. Lahat guilty of sin. Siya lang may right. Bakit hindi niya ginawa yon? Yung mga accusations sa mga scholars sa mundong ito. Lalo't na yung mga Pharisees na yan, na nagmamagaling. They accuse so much against Jesus. You know why? Are you listening me? Are you listening me? Nandyan na ba kayo? Praise the Lord! Why Jesus didn't stone that woman to her death as what Moses law? Because Jesus Christ is about to die at the cross of Calvary. She's supposed to die. Jesus died for her death. He paid the debt of penalty of that woman. Praise the Lord! And He paid all. Suppose that the mga tao sa sanglibutang ito should die, because all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. But Jesus paid for that penalty. Ganun po. Kaya pasalamat tayo sa Diyos. That is His purpose. He is seeking. That's why, yung nasa kay Jesus, there was none of adulterous person being put to death. Walang klaseng mga kasalanan, maliit man malaki, na pinapatay sa harapan ng Diyos. That could only occur if you don't change and you die, then you will be judged without mercy. That's why the Bible says, while you hear the voice of God, harden not your heart, because the moment you can no longer hear the voice of God, you are already over. All you have to do, if you are unforgiven, pag hindi ka napatawad, kay hindi ka nagrepent, hindi ka naghumble, but you went back from your Savior, wala ka. Impierno ka talaga. Kaya, napaka-importante. Mag-humble ka. So, balik tayo doon sa lalaki. Sino kayong lalaki na yun? Yan o anong conviction ko. Sino yung lalaki na yun? I hope, huwag niyo lang sabihin sa iba. I feel it. It is the Pharisee. You cannot trust hypocrite person. You cannot trust a hypocrite person! Kaya hindi nila hinuli yung lalaki. They cannot do. Because they did it. Ang problema lang, pride pa rin. Mataas pa rin ang pride nila. Jesus is opening. When Jesus Christ looked up to the woman, the spirit of truth revealed to the mind into the heart of the woman. And the woman felt that she is really guilty. That is the truth. But all those people who went back, bakit sila umalis? That is an indication they are not willing to acknowledge their sins. They are trying to cover up. Sabihin nila, alam mo yung mga tao na iba na, Lord, help me. Even though I am a sinner, even though I am doing iniquity, help me, Lord, that I can bear it. Make it bearable. Bearable. Anong bearable? Feel mo na yung burden, pero gusto mo pa rin sabihin na bearable, okay lang ito. Kaya lang ito. Dito ka pa rin. Ayaw mo pang lumapit sa Diyos. Ayaw mo pang mag-humble next to that woman. Ayaw mo pa. Sasama ka doon sa mga tao who went back. Then, salvation happened at that moment to only one person who remained in the presence of Jesus Christ. Jesus said, whosoever will come unto me, I will in no wise cast out. Praise the Lord! Ganun din, present time. Tonight, I am calling everybody. I cannot go with crusade in crusade in crusade together with wounded children of God, having not yet purified, having not yet fully surrendered to the Master. You cannot go with me in this battle. Baka maging katulad ka sa tao, hindi sila makabato-bato because they knew it will bounce to death. Mag-bounce talaga if I'm going to throw my stone which I did prepare against this woman. It might kill her, but it will bounce back to me. And it will also kill me too. So therefore, this is now the time for every one of you, the children of God, do not back off Do not be a hypocrite. Humble yourself in the presence of God and make an honest acknowledgement of all sins, small or great, and God will forgive you. And you will be going home with peace of God that passeth all understanding. And let His instruction echo in your ears. Go and sin no more until you die. Praise the Lord. And as I cause you to live, be mine. Thou art mine. Akin ka. You will be the woman of God. You will be the man of God. Tingnan mo yung mga anak ng Diyos dito. What they are being addressed. The man of God. The man of God. Praise the Lord! As we take bow and arrows and open the windows eastward, as God said to the prophet, ask the king Joash to shoot the arrow. The arrow which is the Lord's deliverance. The question is, can you hold that bow? Are you willing to hold that bow? Are you worthy to take arrows and shoot it to an open window eastward? Are you sure that arrow will not return to you? Are you sure that arrow that you shoot, it will not hit you back? So to make it sure, kneel down to the necks of that woman. Praise the Lord! Make it sure. Maligurado lang tayo ng buong puso. Huwag nating sabihin na magmahay diyo ka, Pastor Chit. Ako gani ang mo hawa sa holy place. Naaraba ko'y kuan diri sa holy place. Wow. Magmahay diyo ka. Mangalot diyo ka si imong ulo, way katul. I would like to tell you the truth. The plan of God, the word of God, it will never affect by any one of us. The word of God will be fulfilled by itself without you or with you, without me or with me. Diyan, matutupad at matutupad ang kanyang salita ng Diyos. That's why yung pinakita sa vision at saka sa dream, umaapak ako sa iba-ibang mga nation. Isip ko, Lord, who will listen to me? What crown I'm going to expect if I go that places? If it is not of your power, if it is not of your word that you're going to fulfill, as what you said, that you were shaped all nations. Kaya nag-connect yung sa panaginip ko that I was situated in a tall building and that city shaken. Then people panic and drop down to the ground and crying for help para maghinto yung pag-shake. Puslobas si pastor sa panaginip ko. Pulang-pula yung mukha niya. Mean to say, nag-effort siya ng gusto na sisigaw. Repent! For the kingdom of God is at hand! God is calling all the people of the world to be saved. But He asks you to humble, but He asks you to repent. So only the woman saved at that time because she did repent. Sabi ko, Lord Jesus, how do I start this? Then God convicted me according to the word of God because He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. What He was doing in the old days, 2,000, more than 2,000 years ago, the same He will do it at our present generation. As I study the Bible, I study, as I search, Lord, what I should do, where should, what I must do to start this. Lord Jesus, yun na, it did start at Jerusalem, where He was. So Lord, I am in Takunan, therefore, You ask me to start in this place. It is Your business to perform miracles so that people will be shaken with this news and their desire will come upon you. Kayo ang magtawag ng attention sa mga tao. I have no power to shake the mind and the heart of the people to come and listen my preaching. But if it is You, will do it. 100% it will be done. Praise the Lord! Mangyayari lahat yan. Alam mo anong kinakatakutan ko? Why I must do it with urgency? Bakit takot ako? Bakit kailangan ko nang gawin ito? In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ, the greatest name of all. The most powerful name in all the earth, even in the universe. Bakit? Anong kinakatakutan ko? Alam niyo anong kinakatakutan ko? If I will not do it, God will do it by somebody else. God will do His plan if you do not want to do. Even God already asking you to do and you will not, then God will kick you out and will get another who is willing to do His will. Praise the Lord! Yan ang nasa isip, nasa puso ko. Sigurado yan. Mangyayari talaga yan. Alam mo si Esau? Esau supposed to receive the blessing of his father, Isaac. What God promised to Abraham, to Isaac, Esau supposed to inherit it, the blessing of his father. But what happened? He has no interest. He despised the privilege. He despised his birthright. Therefore, God seek who is interested, since the younger brother has the interest of that blessing which he promised to his father, great, ano yun? Yung lolo niya, grandfather. Siya yung interest. Si Jacob ang interested. That's why God take Jacob in the place of Esau. The same thing will happen to you and to me. If we will not act the action what God asks us to do, no problem. God can take someone in your place, in our place. Ano pa? Naalala niyo si Eli? Si Eli, the high priest. Dapat ang pamilya niya ang mag-inherit sa privilege na binigay ng Diyos sa kanya. But what his sons did? Ano ginawa ng kanyang mga anak? Binaboy nila ang temple. Binaboy nila ang mga offerings ng mga people. Sila mismo with gluttonous behavior, kinain nila. Hindi lang kinain yung karne, pati ang laman ng mga young people, kinain din nila. When God saw it, and Eli cannot discipline them, God said in his mind, I will take the privilege to another. And he gave to Samuel, the little boy. Praise the Lord! Ano pa? Sa buhay ni King Saul. King Saul was anointed by God as the first king of Israel, and his children must be the next of the throne of kingdom of Israel. Pero anong ginawa ni King Saul? Hindi niya ginawa ang pinapagawa ng Diyos who installed him to be the king of Israel. Then, ilang beses niyang inobserbahan ang tao na yan. Puro excuses. Hindi ginawa ang dapat ipagawa to kill all the Amalekites. The Amalekites that represents the devil, the sin of the world. Hindi niya in-execute. Then, God is looking another one. And he found it to the life of a shepherd boy. When God looked all over Israel, he's trying to scan, he's trying to search a heart of a person who has the courage, who has the boldness to take care of the sheep, who is willing even to offer his life just to save the sheep. Then he found it in the heart of David. Huwag nating sabihin, kung wala ka, maapektuhan ang gawain ng Diyos. Never tayo ang maapektuhan. Hindi ang gawain ng Diyos. Naalala niyo yung nangyari sa panahon ni Queen Esther? Ito si Haman, nagpagawa ng decree signed by the King Ahasuerus that all the Jews in this month, in this year, must be executed in the entire kingdom of King Ahasuerus. And it was signed because Esther at that time didn't yet reveal his tribe or his clan. He signed. nung gipos na sa lahat, inannounce na, nagpos na sila ng mga papel na nakasulat doon, itong buwan na ito, itong taon na ito, all Jews, the Jewish people of this kingdom will be killed. Then, Mordecai asked Esther. Kausapin niya si Esther. Esther, since God made you queen and you are the next to the king, I ask you, ask the king to counsel, to defend our lives from sure death. Because it is already a decree, a law. Anong sagot ni Esther? Oh, that is against the protocol. Ilang araw na, the king never asked me to go before him. And if I go before him without his request, the law will be implemented against me. I shall be killed if I approach the king without his order. Anong sagot ni Mordecai? Esther, don't forget, you are a Jew. If you will not go and tell the king, God will use somebody, but you and your family will die. Tingnan mo yan. If you refuse the salvation, if you refuse to save more souls, if you refuse, then God can take another. Sino ang maapektuhan? Those who refuse God. To refuse God is death, because He is life. Alam mo kung meron mang daanan sa sanglibutan ito na pinaka-dangerous, and you cannot stop the thing that is passes that way, yung release ng train. Pagtatayo ka dyan sa release ng train, sasagasaan at sasagasaan ka ng train. Meaning to say, if we will stand against the plan of God, the will of God, no one can stand. No one can remain standing. You will surely fall to your miserable situation. You will die. Yeah, dangerous itong, hindi nyo ba alam? Dangerous masyado itong calling ng Diyos sa buhay natin. This is between life and death. Kaya nga lahat kinakailangan must apply the word of God. Remember, God resisted the proud, but He giveth grace to the humble. Exactly yan yung nangyari sa babae na yan. And we are leading to a greater work of God. And God doesn't use any defiled vessel. So God is counting to all of us. Tick-tack, He is counting. If you refuse, then God will take somebody. God will take anyone of this world in your place. So this is a very serious invitation of God tonight. Tonight, the invitation is tonight. Now is the day of salvation. Now is the accepted time. Now is the day of decision. Before I am going crusade outside, I must do it first with you here. Praise the Lord! So that if I go out and make crusade, I have done inside of my household. Na nasa kamay ninyo ngayon ang decision. The same what happened sa babae na adulterous woman. The same scenario. It is in the hand of everyone. Whether you were go forward and kneel down and raise your both hands and ask forgiveness and acknowledge every sins you have done and receive the forgiveness and receive the assurance of salvation and receive the power of God, so that God said, thou art mine, therefore if you are mine, I will ask you to go and save. Ganun. Pili ka. Nasa kamay natin. Whether we go forward and humble or backward until you will be found no more. Wala na. Babay na. Go home. Buti sana kung mag-go home ka doon sa bosom of Abraham. E kung mag-go home ka in your own way, in your own righteousness, by your hypocrisy, by your pride, remember, all those will go to hell. Papunta yan lahat sa kapahamakan. That's why, tonight, God is inviting you all to kneel down next to that woman. And I will no longer kick you to do it. Hindi ko kayo sisipain para gawin nyo yan. No. Those who are saved up in heaven, they are not being kidnapped. It is out of voluntarism. Voluntary. That's why the Bible says, whosoever believe, whosoever shall believe him shall have everlasting life. Whosoever, hindi pilitan. Sino ang maniniwala? Sino ang mag-humble? Sino ang lalapit? Maliligtas. God is inviting you all tonight. I am not comfortable going outside and do that and do many works of God. And you left behind. That's why I am doing this in the name of Jesus Christ. That's why I ask always, Lord, what I must do? Is there any works to be done before I will go out in your command? Is there anything that I must do? Then God convicted me, this conviction. Chito, you must fix first your own household. They must do the first move to be saved before you can ask outside to be saved. Then it's up to them whether they will do it or not. It's no longer your job. You have done. Then you go. Go and go and go and go and go. And I will go, I will go, I will go where the Lord leads me. Anywhere. Kung yun ang pinakita ni Lord Jesus, I can still reach those countries. So be it. I would be very thankful to God and be very happy. At least the rest of my days will be fruitful, will be used, and God is glorified. God is magnified. God is being exalted. And people will be saved. Marami pang mga tao ang maliligtas. This is serious. This is serious. That's why the Bible says, God is not mocked. Miracles which God made, these were true and serious. These were not done by tricks. These were not done by lies. These were not done by our own. These were done by the hand of God. Therefore, deal with God seriously. We are between life and death. It will depend upon you and me what to choose. You know, what is the situation of life and death, heaven and hell? It is like just like this. This is, you know that line? That is the borderline. This is life and that is death. This is God and this is Satan. It is just a matter of one step. One step lang. Parallel yan. Hindi yan ganyan, ang haba-haba bago mo marating yung impyerno, ang haba-haba bago mo marating yung status na heaven ka. No, it is just a single step. Where you will step on, saan ka aapak? Only single step you need to be saved. Only single step you need to be in hell. It depends upon you. If you ignore God, God will ignore you. If you refuse God, God will refuse you. But if you humble and acknowledge that God will be your king and your heart will be his throne, then God said, welcome. As you welcome me. Praise the Lord! Magsitayo po ang lahat.